Melanie Charlton, and my company is Clos-ette. Really, our trademark is we do holistic organizational design. That's a term we trademarked. And it's all about designing from the inventory out. So we look at function before form. 80% of our projects actually were brought to the project by an interior designer, a design architect, or a decorator, and or the client themselves. And there are those players on the project. So we are really less concerned, although aesthetic is very important to us, with the aesthetic from the forefront. We're really concerned with the functional space design. And so how we look at that is we look at the inventory first, what you're storing in these spaces. And most of our projects are his and her dressing rooms or a his and her walk-in closet. But a lot of our other projects are collection rooms, coat closets, pantries, linen closets, silver and china closets, children's playrooms. It runs the gamut, really. I mean, people get creative all over the place with how and what they need stored. So we look at the functional space design first, the aesthetic second. In a townhouse for a family, often will be brought on early. We'll look at the volume of the inventory versus the geometry of the space, and even pre-plan with clients on how they would allocate certain spaces for the floor plan if they're doing a full renovation. So we're used as a tool, and oftentimes we're just then allowing the design architect or the decorator to put their aesthetic and their stamp onto the spaces. We also do soup to nuts type projects, and often that's when someone comes to us and they say, we're going to convert this entire room into a dressing room. My kids have all gone to college. I'm taking son number three's bedroom and making this my dressing room. Or, the man of the house wants, you know, you guys are going to laugh, but a golf room. Or, he's a collector of stamps or coins. We've done everything, and it's media rooms. We work, with lots of high-end security and storage facilities. So in townhouses, there have been lots of conversions of rooms. Oftentimes, and we'll get to this later in the Q&A, but these homes were not built with storage in mind, not large storage. I've had this business 11 years, and over the last 11 years, I have seen these rooms go from, converting a walk-in closet and dressing up a walk-in closet to really making these rooms almost homes that people hang out in. Often there's TVs, there's a desk, they're functioning in multiple ways. It's a place where the her and the him end up congregating and talking, sometimes having a glass of wine or whatever it may be. This is mainly a shoe closet and handbags, and we did sweaters and hats at the end. So it's mainly accessories. It actually loops around. This was one of those townhouses that was built out to the lot line, and then she took the whole back end of the third floor and made it a dressing room. They put a skylight in this room and in the other room, so we had tons of natural light. The client wrote us when they sold the townhouse. They said that the closet is what sold their house, so they actually signed us up to do something very similar. Even in the walk-ins that we do that are small, that are 8x10, 8x12, we've really been seeing that those have been things when we have a client come back 5 years later that it has really helped with the resale. It's not the forgotten space anymore. This is a townhouse on the Upper West Side. It was a walkthrough to the master bath, and it was his and her dressing room. The sides almost mimicked each other. A very modern designer who worked with us. Simplistic exteriors. Interiors got more complicated as the doors opened. She actually had a whole security system and safe behind one. She didn't have tons and tons of clothing, and she just wanted it very sparse and organized. And so we did that for her. A lot of it was through hardware on the opposite side. This is a townhouse in Chelsea. It's wider at this end, and her husband's side was on the other side, and it was narrower, and he didn't have an island, so we put two islands at this end and made use of the shoe and handbag storage over here for her and made the opposite end his. Oftentimes, we feel like we're therapists through this process, and especially when a him and a her are sharing dressing room space, it's it's something, you know, we've been told we've saved marriages. and we hope we do. We hope that we can act as the peacekeepers, because renovations are painful processes sometimes, but they should be fun. And so this is something where this him actually cared a lot about his side of the dressing room. And sometimes the man doesn't, and sometimes they do. And sometimes when we get in the process, we actually see they care a lot more than they thought they did. This is just a furniture piece that looks like a bureau, but we actually used it for her jewelry storage. And so we do a lot of things that are integrated, so it doesn't all look like blocks of cabinetry. I really, you know, it depends on the client, but sometimes it really is nice to have it make it look like a room. The one last thing I wanted to say is that with closets and the evolution of dressing rooms and all of this, these are some spectacular spaces, but it's also how to tackle the smaller spaces. Oftentimes we're just working within an original floor plan that might be on a historic home. When you're looking at it from a perspective where you just want to maximize every little inch, and you found 2 more feet behind a space, how do we maximize that space? That's really what we feel we're best at, and that's what we really practice.